Okay, so I will be removing this product and redoing the nails with black shellac. So I don't really know what product it is, so I'm going to remove the top coat to make the removal easier. That was pretty soft. Try to file through the base coat, sorry, through the top coat, and usually you can see that because the color changes. So normally when you file, the top coat is kind of like white, and then it changes here. It looks like you've filed through the top coat to expose the product. And I'm gonna do one hand, I'm gonna wrap them, and as they are soaking, I'm going to file the other hand. Speeds up the process a little bit. Here, filing into the color coat. Tight. Make sure this thing is saturated. We're using pure acetone for this removal. This foil is pretty soft, so that's why I put the clips on. Some foils are a little bit tougher and they don't come undone very easily. This one does, so I'm going to use the clips so the product doesn't evaporate, so the remover doesn't evaporate. put a heating pad. Just to speed up the process. Okay, so we'll see if this comes off. This doesn't come off easily. Yeah, it looks like it was shellac with the shellac base coat. It removes just like shellac. These white spots often happen with shellac, and I have no idea what this is. It's like a surface damage. It's not necessarily dryness. It's dryness due to surface damage. But I find with some other products, even though people have damage, they don't have those white spots. I don't know what that is. But we're going to try a different product today, and we'll see if we get the same results. So this was very easy. Okay, I'm going to shorten. with an e-file and then by hand. There is definitely a flake here, and so that flake has to be removed because if the product sticks to the flake and the flake flakes off, then it's just going to chip in like no time. So it is gently. There is no other way. Even with, some people ask, with the IBX, it's not going to permanently bond these layers, so it has to be removed and just prevent it next time with using oil, things like that. Same thing here, there was a little flaky. There's a flake in here as well. Right there. So in here, a little bit of peeling. Thank you. Okay, because these nails are a little bit rounder because they're broken, I'm going to see how the other ones look so they look similar. Okay, I'm gonna make this one a little bit rounder and this one just so they match. So now I'm pushing back the living skin, and I'm doing this gently, so I'm not shoving this tool deep underneath. It's just like nudging it, moving it out of the way so I can remove the cuticle. This is all living skin, and the reason why it's stretched is because it's been stuck to the nail and it grew with it. So if you just push it back gently on a regular basis, this doesn't happen. And the regular basis, it depends on the person. Some people can do that once a week and they're fine. Some people have more of a sticky skin that sticks to the nail and they have to do it once every couple of days. So it really depends. But again, gently, and don't push back. Sorry, don't push down on that nail too much. And progress, not perfection. Just like that. And over time, that skin will exfoliate and it will be, with regular manicures, much nicer. You can see here, I don't have any stretched skin because I pushed it back. And I always recommend urea-based cream because urea is not only hydrating but also exfoliates the skin. So it really, really works well for this area. Now that that skin is pushed back, I'm going to remove the cuticle. And cuticle is this white stuff here. So someone asked me if they can do that without cuticle remover, or actually the video was about with the cuticle remover. And yes, you can do it, but then you have to put more pressure on the nail. So I prefer to do that with e-file. But if you're doing this yourself, then you can definitely use cuticle remover. The reason why I'm not using cuticle remover here is because I prefer to, well, shellac sticks better, and a gel product sticks better to a very, very dry surface. So now I'm just catching the cuticle, removing it. If that skin is dry, you can't fix dry skin with filing it. That's not how it works. You have to use creams and you have to protect that skin. Filing it will make it worse. And as you can hear, hopefully, this is done on a very, very low speed. I'm also not shoving this tool underneath that skin, because this, the proximal nail fold, is a, it's like a barrier, and it protects the matrix underneath, the area where the nail is growing, from infections. So you don't want to be messing with it too much. Gentle pushback is okay, but aggressive treatments cause more issues. The nail can permanently be damaged sometimes if there is an infection in that area. I'm just smoothing this lifted here part. Again, the most important thing is to understand that what I'm doing now here is not, I'm not removing dry skin here. I'm just smoothing it a little bit. Because usually there are a little bit of calloused areas here. But again, if you do that too much, then you actually is, you're going to create a callus, because if you create inflammation, that creates callus, and friction can definitely make the nails worse or the skin worse. As you can see, there's not a lot of dust created because I'm not removing a lot. Cuticle is very thin. And if you see a lot of dust being created, that's usually the nail that's being filed. Especially when people file too much on the sides, they definitely catch the nail, and then the nails get very thin and they tend to break over here. Going to clip this later. Again, there's a little flake here. Let's try to smooth it. Okay, now I'm gonna use a buffer just to smooth the uneven area, but just very, very gently. Product nail-based products stick pretty well to natural nail as long as it's healthy. So the less amount of buffing I have to do, the better. Give them a good scrub with alcohol, 99% alcohol, making sure I get all the dust in the corners and the free edge. This product really feels like nail polish, so you can't go over the area multiple times, but it's really thin. It sets, so it doesn't need to be flush cured really. The Manucurist lamp has a setting, base color and top, so I just follow the settings. There's a little bit of cuticle left here. This coat really flows into those white spots, really nicely covering them. It's interesting. This lamp is a little bit tricky because in order to sometimes have the thumb under a proper angle, the other nails are sticking, the other fingers are sticking out a little bit. So sometimes maybe curing it twice would be a good idea. So this looks quite dry, which is good. That means that the color is not going to slide on top of it. So I'm going to apply a thin coat. The brush is so-so with this color. Again, just like nail polish, this one gives you some resistance. you can feel that it's setting up, so you can't go over the same area multiple times to stretch it, but you don't have to because it's such a thin application. The brush could be better. Second coat is usually a little bit easier and a little bit faster because we already have the borders. But I try to perfect the borders with the second coat, usually. This gives you a good coverage, the second coat. So the color coats cure in 1 minute. Top coat is a little tricky. If you wrap the free edge, there's going to be like a bump, I find. Let's see. Or you have to wrap it very, very lightly, like barely on the product. Okay, I think this touched the lamp a little bit. So in this case, just going to touch up the edge. And cure it again. The lamp is open on both sides, so I'm a little bit scared that the light is going to hit the brush and it's going to harden it. So you have to make sure you work away from the light, like far away. Because UV is invisible and you can't really see that it's polish being exposed. So the top coat looks like it requires like a medium coat. Can't be too thin. Now I'm going to flush cure it because I definitely don't want this in the skin. And the top coat is a no wipe top coat, which I'm not sure how I feel about it, because even the no wipe top coats have a bit of a inhibition layer, and that layer is highly allergenic, so you have to be careful. But we're going to be putting matte nail polish, so we're going to be covering it. And for a good measure, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it under the light, not to cure the polish, the regular polish, but the coat underneath will be exposed to UV again, and it might cure better. To use Sally Hansen. So this is a regular polish, and we're doing this just because we are trying to create a matte manicure. The brush in this brand is a little not that great. The lamp is a little confusing, it keeps kind of resetting itself. I'm used to the CND lamps where it's, well, the old lamp used to beep, which was great. Okay. Yeah, it feels a little rubbery initially, but I think after a while that goes away. Now cure the other hand. Well, dry it under the lamp. Let's just put it this way. Okay. Mm-hmm. I have to say the lamp is a little warm. Let this dry for a minute. Okay, so now oil, because they look pretty dry. So the oil is going to make them a little bit less matte, but it is what it is. After you wash your hands, it's going to be less shiny again. It's dried very quickly. Snip these little couple pieces that were in need of snipping. I think that was it. Looks really good, I have to say. It's very nice and thin.